say I'm 90% for it. There are a few provisions that I'm not happy. But like as a mom, as a province, for example, you see all these moms. They always get pregnant every year. Every year, they can't do anything. Wala sila pang clean up. These people make less than 50 pesos a day. So, push yun sa pagkain pa lang nila. Diba? At saka sa baon ng pinapin. But that's really who the RH bill is for. Yeah. For people like that.
It's to provide for them.
It's for people in the provinces who don't have money to buy their own contraceptives, who don't have access to the internet to search for how to plan their family or to talk about, to understand maternal mortality, maternal health, things like that. So, I think definitely good yun for women. It's good for youth to educate them. Because tayo, you think there's the average Filipino father talks to his or mother talks to their children about sexual health? I don't think so. Especially father. But can you imagine him talking to Provinciano, talking to his daughter? Talaga yun. Kailangan sa public school. Ang tanong na lang, what is the appropriate age?
Grade
5, grade 6, grade 7. Sa akin, nothing lower than grade 6 or 7. Anything lower. Because if the children don't get it in their household, they don't get it in their school. They're gonna get it on the internet. They're gonna see it on the media. That's worse. Diba? So, sa akin, okay lang. Kami sa private school. And we were taught it. So why not teach it in public school? Where they have less access. Hindi ko lang gusto ng yung provisions on ideal family size. They say that 2 is the ideal family size. But they say that would be removed. Okay, 3 children. So, so, kaya naman natin paralit. So, I don't see why we should be telling people how many kids they should have. And, ayoko rin yung provision na where the bill says that those with over 100 employees, businessmen, lawyers, must also provide contraceptives to their employees. Hmm? In a way, that already goes one step further. And, others argue that the state shouldn't be doing that. Ako, I believe the state should, but I don't think we should impose it upon individuals, especially how to run their business. Sa akin, let's leave it to the state. The state, and then we give them a choice. Because people have their own individual business. What if that business owner is a member of a certain religious group and that goes against their view? It's going too far naman to ask individuals to insert specific things. We can ask the state to provide, to make provisions for certain things. You know? Let's not impose our own beliefs on individuals. Well, according to TV, it's the Tanya the bill. But there's other authors also.
Yes.
In fact, we've been pushing for that for 3 congresses. It's my first traveling. I've had a discussion in previous congresses. And the only sticky point that I see, which could be holding it up, is your right to reply, inclusion of the provision of the right to reply. Right to reply was originally a separate bill, which mandates that anybody about whom it's written about in a negative or derogatory manner may write to respond in the same forum, in the same manner, let's say front page or different front page response. Inirasan ang 1.5 minutes sa radyo, dapat 1.5 minutes din sa kanya. So you know, that's something that I don't think the authors will have an easy time agreeing on. Because some of the proponents of that feel na pag hindi nasama yon, deal breaker yon, they will no longer support the bill. Iba naman, who support the bill, say that's a deal breaker in the sense that if it is included, they will no longer support the bill. So the people tend to prosper with the offer. My running depends on whether I'm chosen by the whole region as one of these candidates. As of now, nagpapakit tayo, but wala pang final goal.
ating presidente. We're choosing from 15. Narrow it down to 13. So I don't know. Baka ako yung pang 13. Let's wait for that. Or, that's why I've been very careful in saying whatever we ran. Hindi ko kontrolado yun, in other words. Pero definitely, kung nasama tayo doon, I'll be ready. So sa akin, it's not something I'm consciously trying to do to separate myself from that. Because, number one, I think he's left a great legacy of loss. And I think that ultimately, that's a benefit not only to me, but to all Filipinos. So it's not something I'm consciously trying to separate myself from. I'm trying to make my own name, but to separate myself from Centro and Lagay, I'm not really trying to do that because it's associated with education, it's associated with agriculture, with health. I think those are all panalo lang na that issue na yun. So, and I think there's still a lot of work to be done. Education, siya nagpataas ng sweldo ng students, we have free high, teachers, free high school, the government, the biggest government scholarships, siya nag-author, new creation of test, etc. But I think one aspect that maybe he didn't see so much is yung how to improve the economy to create more jobs for his graduates. So that's something I want to work on for the future. Still health, I think it's time we came up with a, that's his law, no? Pero it's time we also came up with a more comprehensive health policy, which includes how we employ our health professionals, like our nurses, and then also our public hospital system. Agriculture, definitely, nakakalimutan niya. There's not very many officials pushing for food security. Definitely, I think there's no need to really dissociate myself. What I think there's a need for is to continue the legacy. It's not perfect. I think there's aspects to him that I see na, okay, I think I can improve on that. Like, different. But by and large, what I do idolize is yung vision niya. He's thought of things that a lot of people have not thought of. Yung, it's always long-term. Yung pagiging masipag niya. Wakes up at 5 in the morning. It's working. At by 6:37, you're ready at his first appointment. And he works the whole day. And yet he has time for us, his family. He's a very well-rounded person. He doesn't ignore yung life of the mind. Nagpapasawala siya. Even at 7-8, he's still trying to improve what he knows. You know, the things which I admire about him. But it's not perfect. Education is number one. Because that was his first advocacy. And then later on, he moved to other advocacies. Education, para nakalimutan. No one took that. No one else in the younger generation took up education as their main in the Senate. Even in Congress, walang plans. So, there's a need to revisit education. Like we're spending billions for scholars. There's not a single study in the Philippine educational system. I was shocked when I was chairman of the higher tech education. I was asking the education minister, there's no study which tracks all of these scholars of the government. There's not. So I told the CHED, we have to commission a study. Because otherwise, how do we know 15 years of the CHED is working at least every year about 60,000 scholars? We have no idea where they are. Are they OFW? Have they come back and become productive to our country? We don't know. How do we know where we... How can we more decide from now on about every scholarship that any tracking system? It's the day and age of the internet where it's so easy to track the whereabouts of people. Alumni associations can we can piggyback on them, find out. So otherwise, how do we know which investments will be worthwhile?
And then I talk to my local chief, police. So bakit ninyo alam? Sir, taga-Nevesi or taga-Nevesi, they are wanted there. Oh, pati niyo arrest ko, hindi niyo hanapin, maglagay kayo ng wanted post. Sir, hinihintay pa namin yung pictures namin sa provincial PNP nila. In other words,
walang alam.
Each provincial police is like its own separate kingdom. Can you imagine? It's so easy to just click on your computer and say, ito pala yung baka ito yun, di ba?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's a basic example. Another example is LTO, car registration, you know? It's so easy to know who has the real license plate, who's using a fake license plate. If you just automate it everywhere. But these are things where in the government, I think even regular citizens would be better in coming up with solutions rather than who's already there. There's a lack of common sense in government sometimes. I think so. Because now, lumindol palagas,
yeah,
di ba?
Yeah.
Oh, what if that happened in a school day? What? How would people know about it? That's an easy suggestion. It's a disaster where you file the papers for that. But it's a calamity fund. I'm suggesting that schools be made to avail also. Kasi yung nakalabi yung mga luwa. Kasi pag schools made available to schools, is yung repair. Ano? Kasi may nung bagyo, nung ikot kami yung pinto, may naman napuntahan kaming schools. One side, okay. Pero yung isang side, sira na, for example. Tapos, na-comment ni presidente, ito, ayusin natin. Tapos, may sumigaw na matanda. Ah, basyang pa yan. Type, basyang
yan.
It was last video. So, siguro, hindi rin sapat yun. May response fund kasi yan. Maybe it's not sufficient. Parang hindi tayo maghintay for, kasi if you go through the normal budget process, matagal yun, you have to protect the DPM, the department presents it to the DPM, and then the DPM finds it pa, tapos may release ng pera, matagal eh. But if there's already a fund there, that will answer for those contingencies. That's the National Disaster Calamity Fund. So kung isama natin yung mga schools na mas makapagal. I definitely think plagiarism is wrong. As someone who studied abroad, it's taken very seriously. You don't seem to take it very seriously. So it's good that something like that happened. Now that, in a way, making examples. Yeah, because if someone like that high doesn't take it seriously, but then he was taken to task. But to be fair to Senator Soto, I think he naman siya susunod, knowing Senators, congressmen, how busy they are. Hindi talaga sila ang
susunod
ng speeches nila. So I think the one who has to answer for them is
staff.
So next time, it's easy. It's not a big big issue in terms of coming up with a solution. The next, the only solution is attribute.
Yeah.
Attribution. Yeah. You made a mistake. Own up to it. MVP.
Define love.
Define love. Secretary Mar is comfortable with figures, it's a technocrat. He's comfortable with talking to CEOs and businessmen. Ito, iba to, you know. But I think since he's been in national elections, Thank you. Nice to meet you all.